Matt, we're in one of the oldest and, dare I say it, most comprehensive places to see crocodiles in all of Queensland. This is Hartley's Creek. It's been exhibiting crocodiles in this one place since 1935. This is the first place in Queensland to breed crocodiles in captivity, and we've still got a whole pile of them here. It's been a Queensland institution in terms of the tourism industry and in terms of how people not only look at crocodiles, but we hope that the visitors, when they come here, go away with increasing understanding. Even if they don't like them, they can just go away, and the next time they see one in a zoo or somewhere else, they can, or even in the bush, they can see them and go, wow, I've got to behave appropriately when I'm in their country. And that's the message that we try to get across here. Sustainable interactions with the animals. They're not going anywhere. People tried to get rid of them in the 50s, 60s and 70s. They couldn't. The crocs are too good at what they do.
What makes them really good at what they do?
Oh, where do you start? I mean, they're the supreme wetland predator. One way to really annoy the staff in this institution is to refer to crocodiles as being vicious and primitive. Mm-hmm. They are one of the most sophisticated animals. They're the supreme wetland predator because they work in the murky line, you know, between the water and the land, and where land animals come down to drink. You know, they're out of their comfort zone, aquatic animals, the water's getting shallow, the crocs are just in there waiting for any mistakes. They're reptiles, so they don't need to feed every day. They are creatures of infinite patience, incredible strength in their jaws, as I'm sure you've already seen, and they use those to devastating effect. Well, we're zookeepers, of course. You know, we maintain a diverse collection of Australian fauna, not just crocodiles. The main aim, if there's an aim of the park at all, it's to illustrate how crocodiles interact not only with their own habitat requirements, but with all the other animals and plants that make up tropical North Queensland. And that, of course, includes people. So a great deal of the role of the park here and the role of the staff here is to deliver really cutting-edge interpretational information in the shows and in the passive in the handouts and just in people walking around taking in the landscaping of the park to get an understanding of how the crocodile's role in its environment and what we can do to promote that while at the same time being aware and living safely in crocodile country. So we do a lot of shows, a lot of talks, a lot of effort in this park is given over to helping people understand. Because a lot of people visit here, they're on their way to somewhere else. They're on their way up to the Cape, a fishing trip or something. They may not know that. You know, they may not. Other information may be hard to come by. So if they come here, they can learn just everything they need to know to behave safely, have a great time, and you know, have a really relaxing, worthwhile holiday, and hopefully take an appreciation of their environment home. Extreme fishing.
Yeah, seriously. That's twice I got knocked off. Unbelievable. Way too slow today.